In this video, we will be looking at solids, liquids, and gases. Materials come in three different forms: solids, liquids, and gases, also known as the three states of matter. You must be able to describe the particle arrangement for each state and link this to its properties. So let's start with solids. Solids have their particles close together in a regular arrangement. There are strong forces of attraction between the particles, so they don't move but vibrate around fixed positions. The particles in a liquid, although close together, are able to slide past each other, as the forces of attraction between the particles are weaker. The particles in a gas have very weak forces of attraction between them, so the particles can move randomly and quickly in all directions. As we can see, the energy of the particles increases, going from a solid to a liquid to a gas. The opposite is true for density, which will decrease going from a solid to a liquid to a gas. Make sure you can apply this arrangement to any given substance in an exam. Let's have a closer look at the properties for each state. The particles in a solid are unable to move and have no spaces between them, so a solid is rigid and maintains a fixed shape and a fixed volume. Because of this, a solid cannot be compressed when pressure is applied. Solids also have a high density. The particles in a liquid are also close together, so like a liquid is hard to compress. Because the particles in a liquid are able to move over each other, liquids do not have a fixed shape, so they can flow and take the shape of their container. They do, however, have a fixed volume. Some students find them having a fixed volume but not a fixed shape confusing. So imagine you have 1 litre of water. You cannot change the volume of the water to suddenly become 2 litres, but you can pour the water to fit the shape of different containers. Liquids have also got a lower density than solids. The particles in a gas move quickly and randomly in all directions. A gas, therefore, has no fixed shape or volume and will completely fill a container. Due to the particles in a gas being far apart with large spaces between them, a gas can easily be compressed. The particles will also collide with each other as well as with the surface of the container they are in, which creates pressure. They have a much lower density than solids and liquids. This question asks you about the separation, arrangement, and motion of particles in element X, which you are told is in the solid state. The question is 3 marks, so you will score 1 mark for a statement addressing each of the terms in the question. To help you answer, think about the structure of a solid we looked at earlier. Looking at this model, we can see that the particles are close together, which answers the separation element of the question for 1 mark. The particles have a regular arrangement, which will score your 2nd mark. And they are unable to move properly, they just vibrate around fixed positions, which scores your 3rd mark. Make sure for any question on states of matter that you refer to particles within your answer, instead of generic terms like they. This question is extremely similar to the one we've just looked at, but is asking you to describe the arrangement and separation of the molecules in hydrogen chloride gas. This question is 2 marks, so again, it will be 1 mark for describing the separation of the particles and another for describing the arrangement. The structure of a gas is shown here. As we can see, the particles are far apart from each other, which addresses the separation element of this question for 1 mark, and they are arranged randomly, which scores the 2nd mark. You would also score the 2nd mark for saying that the particles are not in fixed positions or they are not in a fixed arrangement. To summarise, there are 3 states of matter: solids, liquids, and gases. The particles in a solid vibrate around fixed positions, meaning that solids have a fixed shape and a fixed volume. The particles in a liquid are able to move over each other, which means that liquids have a fixed volume but not a fixed shape. The particles in a gas are far apart and move quickly in all directions, meaning that gases have no fixed shape or volume. Make sure you can describe the arrangement, movement, separation, and energy of the particles and relate this to a substance's properties. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.